Each time a man stands up for an ideal, or acts to improve the lot of others, or strikes out against injustice, he sends forth a tiny ripple of hope, and crossing each other from a million different centers of energy and daring, those ripples build a current which can sweep down the mightiest walls of oppression and resistance.
Malcolm Gladwell's groundbreaking debut book made the tipping point everyone's go-to phrase to describe that moment when critical mass reaches a boiling point. The book delves into what makes ideas, products, and messages spread quickly. His answer is people. People who possess a rare set of social gifts that fall into one of three categories: communication, teaching, or sales. Exceptional talent in one of these areas helps transform a simple idea into a phenomenon. Gladwell could dedicate a whole chapter to our next Ripple of Hope winner. She defies even his model by possessing not one, not two, but all three of his rare social gifts. Victoria Harding is an exception and exceptional by any measure. There is no greater testimony to Tori's talents than the National Capital NeuroRestorative Program we highlighted just a few moments ago. It's not an understatement to say that the creation of this program, from its conception and design to its development and execution, was Tori's baby. With a staggering number of veterans returning from war with brain injuries, she saw an opportunity to offer residential services within a short distance of Walter Reed National Military Medical Center. It would be a place to serve, but also to showcase the therapeutic possibilities of residential treatment. I have been so fortunate and humbled to meet these men and women who have served honorably, to hear their stories of bravery and humility and terror and regret and joy, said Tori. We owe it to them to do this important work. Tori's development of the National Capital Program was a natural extension of her tireless efforts to bring traumatic brain injury rehabilitation services to veterans around the country, as well as to the general population. She is NeuroRestorative's Vice President of Marketing and Development. There is a direct line from Tori's actions to more people actually receiving the quality services they need, said Jody Crowley, NeuroRestorative's Regional Vice President and Tori's nominator. NeuroRestorative has become a leading provider of traumatic brain injury services to veterans, and states like Maryland are now offering community-based brain injury services for the very first time. Civilians and soldiers finally have the opportunity to heal within the security and comfort of their own neighborhoods, within easy reach of their support systems. Tori makes bold moves, offered Jody. She is a risk taker, and she knows how to convey a vision that convinces people it's a risk worth taking. She has the knowledge and credibility that come with being a clinician and a former operations manager. Another secret of her success, according to Jody, is her ability to establish and maintain relationships. You are immediately taken by Tori. She just pulls you in. Her style of communicating is dynamic, Jody explained. She has a sincere interest in people and what makes them tick. For Tori, people are a lifelong interest. That's what led her to a degree in speech-language pathology, specializing in cognition. Of all the things that connect people, that make community happen, it's really communication and thinking, and that's our brain, Tori said. I was interested in how that worked. If we could harness it, we would have a better world. Her clinical background and operations experience give her a rare vantage point from which to develop and evaluate programs and services. It also creates a special connection between Tori and those she serves. She understands their challenges. She feels their family's pain. She speaks their language. Tori worked with them first as a young clinician, later as an operations manager, and today as a seasoned business leader. Yet her goal remains the same, healing. In typical fashion, she refuses to accept any credit for her accomplishments. Truth be told, Tori worked hard to have this award rescinded. Instead, she focuses squarely on those she serves and their families. She keeps photos of them on her desk. I've had this great opportunity to travel around America, she mused, and I've learned that change always boils down to this: one pissed off parent. She recalls many families in which every single member was inspired to action by the injury of their soldier. My job is to soften their long, hard journey, she went on. We get the honor of riding shotgun beside them. We celebrate, we cry, we're planting hope in them. Tori, a native of Canada, recently became an American citizen. Being the diligent student, she relished the chance to take her citizenship test. One question gave her pause. What is one promise you make when you become a United States citizen? There were multiple answers from which to choose. She settled on serve. She thought about her job, no, her mission. I truly believe, explained Tori, that the work NeuroRestorative does every day helps fulfill the promise I made, a promise that every American citizen carries. Tori Harding, for using your rare gifts and formidable skills to create opportunities for rehabilitation where none existed, for offering hope to those grappling with the tragedies of war, and for taking on their burdens as your own, and for dedicating your education and your career to unlocking the mysteries of the brain so that your fellow citizens might live healthier, happier, more fulfilling lives, I am proud to present you with the Ripple of Hope Award.